Three books. See, this color is helium. This is iskium. This is cubus. First, if you take the helium, it is wide above, prismatic in the middle, slightly expand the lower part. It has two surfaces, three borders, and three angles. See, this is called lateral surface. It is wide and concave in the upper part. In the lower part, you can see the rough lines. These are called as gluteal lines. It is intended for the gluteal muscles. See, this is the medial surface. You can see a line is there. This is the iliopectoral line. The iliopectoral line divides the surface into two areas. The rough area is triangular. It is called sacral surface. Here the sacrum will be articulating with each other. See, this is the smooth surface. It is quadrilateral in shape. It is covered by a muscle that is called iliacus. So the iliopectoral line continues downward. In the middle it appears a tubercle. That is called psoas tubercle. Then the iliopectoral line continues downward. It joins with the anterior border of the pubis. So the two surfaces are over. If you take three borders, see this is the lateral border. It is concave. It forms the great prismatic notch. Then it continues downward as a convex area. This is called ischial spine. This is called ischial spine. See, this is the dorsal border. It is concave. It forms the croup region. See, this is the cartilaid border. It is concave. It joins with the acetabulum. Three borders over. Three angles. This plus medial angle is called supersacral. It joins with the sacrum. It forms the point of the croup. That is the highest point of the animal. Whenever you want to get the height of the animal, you should get the point of the croup. This plus lateral angle. That is called supercoccyx. See, this is called as acetabular angle. It joins with the other four bones. It forms the acetabulum. This is about the ilium. The ischium, this is the ischium. It is quadrilateral shape. See, from here onwards, this is ischium. It has two surfaces. This surface is called pelvic surface. It is smooth, concave. It forms the posterior part of the floor of the pelvic cavity. The ventral surface, see, this is the ventral surface. It is rough. In the middle of the ventral surface, there is a tuberosity there for the attachment of muscles. It has four borders. See, this is the lateral border. It continues from the ischial spine. It is also concave. It forms the lesser sciatic notch. See, this is the medial border. It is straight. When it joins its fellow, it is forming a joint that is called ischial symphysis. In the ischial symphysis,